Hello friends, today we are going to learn lookup data table. So for this, I have taken this Excel file where we have the ID, name, phone number, location and department. So let me show you the demo. The lookup data table activity is going to look up, let's say, location of each employee when we search for it. Let me run the demo and then we will go in detail. Okay, so before that, let me close this file. Let me run it again. Okay, so it's asking the employee name. Let's say I'm entering the employee name and it's giving me the location. Okay, so how do you accomplish this? So let's get started. So the very first thing that I will do is I'm going to use an activity called read range. Okay, now here I'm going to mention which is that file I want to read. So I have a file in my documents already saved and you saw that file. So I'm going to link that to the same file and then I want to read the sheet 1 and I don't want to read from A1 to A2, rather I want to read the entire range. So just put a double quote, so that should do the job. And one more thing to remember, by default add header is selected. We need to keep that selected because we'll be using the headers. Okay, so once it reads it, it should store the data in the output, right? So I'll create a variable for that, Control K. And here I will say, you know, input data. So this will become our input data, which we'll be using to search. So I'll create a variable called input. Okay. All right. So now once the data is read and, you know, put into the data table called input, I want to ask the customer what he wants to search for, right? So for that, I'll use an input dialog. And here I'm going to say, enter the employee name. Okay, the moment he enters the employee name, that should get stored in a variable, right? So Control K, this will be user input. All right, and the previous one is, this is the data table I've created, right? As input is our data table and this one is our user input. Okay, the best practice is while you create a variable, you know, keep it what is required. You know what you are doing exactly, that you should keep. For example, read range. So what is the mistake here? If you say input, you might get confused. So the best thing is you correct this, Control K, and make it as input data table, you can say, or anything which is much more relevant, so that nobody get confused when they read your variable. And here I'm saying user input. Okay. Now the one more thing I have to do is, because I have created two data tables, let me delete the previous one. Understood? So it is a good practice to create a variable as per the necessity activity is being done. Okay, so that it is well understood throughout the project. Okay, so this is the user input. Now once the user input is done, the next activity that we should be learning is our this type data table, and here you have all the activities, correct? So now we are in the previous video, we spoke about join data table. This one is for the lookup data table. So I will just drag and drop the lookup data table. Okay, now one thing, when you look at the right, you know, it might be overwhelming with lot of properties. That is something one needs to understand and learn. Okay, so lookup data table, the first thing we need to ensure, what is the data table? Right here, our data table name is input DT, right? So I'm selecting input DT. Done. Then lookup value. So lookup value, whatever this customer is entering, the same thing it should search in that data table, right? So the lookup value is coming from this variable, user input. So let me enter that user input. Okay, so now it will search inside the data table, where is that user. Let's say I'm entering Deepak. It will search, okay, Deepak. Okay, now for that, which column it should search? So there are so many columns. Which column Deepak is available, which cell, which column it falls in? So if you remember the Excel file, let me open it. So the Deepak Kumar, the name is there in the name column, right? The column name is, the header is name. So that is what you have to indicate in UiPath, that you should go and look inside the column name. Okay. And the other way to do that is column index. So I think I have covered in the previous chapters. So this is the zero index, this is the one index. So if I, instead of writing name, I can also, you know, keep just type an index one. So I don't have to do that because I am using column name here, but you can try, you know, you can just put one here, that will do the same job. Okay, so this is covered. Now the next thing is output, right? Once it finds where that output should be written, so there should be a variable. So control K, I will create a variable called output. Okay, done. Output variable is created, but what is that output? From where you want to fetch that output? So we want, when I'm entering the employee name, I want the location, correct? I want the location. So I will say column name as, but guys, there is a couple of error scenario that I'm going to cover. Okay, do not stop the video just here. There's a couple of error scenarios that I'm going to cover. Just continue the video for some time. Okay, now here is the location I've covered. Okay, now you know, location and the variable cell value output I have covered, right? Now here my location is a string type, correct? So if I go back to variable, and here I am going to output should be a string type. Let's say I'm converting this to string type. Okay, now I wanted to show that in a message box. Okay, so I have to say, so the input, right, that is user input, that will come the, which will hold the employee name, right? So Deepak Kumar, for example, Deepak Kumar, give a plus sign, and I am saying is from, okay, give a plus sign, and then here I am going to say the other variable which will be output. So sorry, one second, let me do control G, by mistake I've deleted that, let me retry. Go to activities and drag and drop the message box. Okay, now in the message box I wanted to say Deepak Kumar, the employee name what has entered is from so and so location. So I'll use the variable user input, okay, and then plus, and then say is from, give a space, and then plus, and just say output. Output is your variable, right, which contains the location. So let me run this and show you, then you will understand. Then I am going to cover the error scenarios. Okay, so before you run, I always make this mistake, close the Excel file. Okay, so the very first thing it is asking, enter the employee name. Let's say I'm entering Deepak Kumar is from Bangalore. So it has shown in the proper format you want. For that I have written in this way, user input is from, output. So I have created so many multiple videos on message box, how you you know, design a message box the way you want. So you can watch those videos as well. All right, so this is done. Now what I was saying is, right now I have pulled the location where it belongs. What if I wanted to pull, let's say I'm entering a name and I want to pull the phone number. Okay, so you see there's a phone number. So what you should do, you will go back here, go to lookup table, and here you are saying column name, instead of column name you will use that column name which is phone number, right? So let's say I'm saying phone number. Now we will see what is the problem here. Okay, phone number, done. So ensure the the spelling is appropriate and it's in the proper case. Okay, so now I have typed it. Now here I will say instead of anything, I'll just simply say output. Otherwise, I can just Deepak Kumar's phone number is something you can write. Okay, it should show me the phone number, correct? That is how it's supposed to work. Now, let me close this. We'll see the error. What the error? What is the error? Okay, so asking the employee name. Let's say I'm entering Deepak Kumar. It's saying lookup data table string converter cannot convert from system.double, right? It's not doing the job. Okay, guys, when you encounter this error, this is just because the output, let me show you the output that you have declared, right? The data type, if you remember. Now the data type you have declared is, let's say, output. If you go variable and you are making it output a string, let's say I'm going to make it integer because phone number will be integer, you'll still see this problem. Okay, now many people might get this problem and this will be error scenario. Okay, so let me run it. And it's asking for the employee name. I'm entering Deepak Kumar. So again, this error, right? Integer 32 converter cannot convert from system.double. Okay, so how do you fix this problem? Okay, this is the practical problem you will face while running the lookup data table. So how do you fix that? Okay, the simple solution for that is, while you are declaring an output variable for lookup table, I would recommend not to specify that. Okay, rather than in integer 32, what I will do, I will just make it as generic value. Okay, so when I say generic value, let me run it, you will see the difference. Okay, now it's saying enter. Deepak Kumar phone number is so and so. Now you can see how nicely you have fixed the problem. Alright guys, so thank you. This is one of the error scenario. Thank you very much. Guys, please do subscribe to the channel. Do hit on the like and comment. Thank you very much. You have a wonderful day.